The Honorable Malema.
Thank you very much. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate Mbokoto Mkhonto Wesizwe Thandi Modise, the militant and uncompromising woman who led from the front when it was not fashionable to do so. Here the ANC has managed to deploy a trusted force of our people. And for that, we congratulate you. We hope we'll work together, Metandi. There will be heated moments. There will be a robust debate. You should never degenerate and be partisan when the House degenerates. You should remain a speaker and be a speaker of all of us. Because if you degenerate, you'll never get this House in order. Always know that you might be coming from a particular political party, but sitting up there, you now preside over all of us. We are all your children, and you must not discriminate us. Treat us equally with respect, we'll return the favor. Once we feel targeted and neglected and rejected, we shall show you the other side of us. So if we all treat each other with respect, we have nothing to worry about. We grew under your leadership, and we know when we see you, we see Winnie Mandela in action. And we are happy that you are not part of the people who once denounced and disowned Winnie Mandela. You stood with her when it was not fashionable to do so. That's why you are a dependable force of our people. Deputy Speaker, we congratulate you and we hope that we'll work together for the next 5 years. You had a difficulty with 25. I don't know how you'll manage with 44. I hope that you'll indeed try to navigate through and make sure that we succeed. Comrade President, we congratulate you and we hope that you will be a president of a corrupt-free government. And you will not subject yourself to views of factionalism. There are people who thrive through patronizing presidents. They tell you all you want to hear. And as a result, you are unable to make informed decisions because you surrender yourself with praise singers and yes men and yes women. I've seen young men and women from the benches of the ANC. Maybe it is time to consider them so that they can come to you with fresh ideas, with new ideas, and if they don't like positions, they will be able to be honest with you. You need someone who's going to be honest with you. The position you occupy needs someone who's going to be honest with you, because those who failed were told many a times that they are right even when they were wrong. Even when the Constitutional Court said to them, you are wrong. Even when the Public Protector said to them, you are wrong. Those around them kept on telling them they are right. And that's why they got it wrong. You must never ever listen to those who say you are right against the courts of South Africa, against Chapter 9 institutions of South Africa. Those are the institutions which are meant to defend our democracy, and they will forever guide us. So, President, there are people who served long in cabinet from Mandela's time. I have nothing against them. And I don't know why they don't make your work easy by coming to you and say, we are not available, maybe as advisors. So that they give room to new ideas. Comrade President, Stellenbosch is a big problem. We know your proximity to Stellenbosch. We know your proximity to Oppenheimers. We have not elected Oppenheimers. We have not elected Stellenbosch yet. I told your predecessor in 2011 that we have not elected the Guptas. We elected him. and he must lead us. He refused to listen to that. We're warning you, President. We have not elected the Ruperts yet. We have not elected the Oppenheimers. Listen to the collective wisdom of people you are elected with, not white monopoly capital. It will not be here to defend you. Once you listen to white monopoly capital, you must know that you are likely not to finish your term. All the best, President. We are here. We are watching you. And we'll continue to engage you openly, not in secret. Thank you.
Umntana akaphinda angene ushenge.